All right, so hey there guys. I'm going to talk about adding color to this project, most specifically the pumpkin itself. So I know working from home you don't have everything that we have here in school, but I bet you have the things that you need to complete this. So first of all, for your background areas and all the little objects that you completed, we are using some different things here in school. We're using some watercolor pencils, we're using some watercolor crayons, some watercolor paint, but we also have the option of just using straight up crayons and straight up colored pencils. So if you would, for me, just go ahead and use crayons and colored pencils to color in your objects. So for instance, I'm coloring in one of my apples and I'm trying to keep it darker around the edges, and then as I color in the middle, I am just doing it a little bit lighter, just so that there is some shading there. Now, because we're using the watercolor pencils here in class, ours do have a little bit more of that shading feel to it, but you can do pretty much the same thing at home, just doing it darker around the edges and then coloring it in lighter towards the middle. Okay? So once you have that done, you can certainly color the whole thing with crayons, colored pencils, you can even use markers in the background. I do think it's a little bit easier to fill in the larger areas with watercolor. So I'm going to choose a color that's not in that space, and I'm going to fill in the background. And I'm not going to sit here and do that whole thing because I think you get the hint, the gist of this. So go ahead and just make sure that when you're all done, you don't have any big empty spaces that you'll need to fill in, okay? The only other thing I want to tell you, this is actually one of my 7th graders. How'd that get under there? One of my 7th graders just turned that in today. So the only other thing I want you to be aware of, if you did a space that has a lot of small, close together lines, like this spider web section, if that is the case for you, and just wash off my brush. Do pick a color that you think would go well with it. I mean, you can do black and really water it down. I'm going to grab some purple. And if you add enough water to your watercolor paint, the pigment will be very light and you should be able to see those Sharpie lines through the paint. Okay, so I would just recommend trying to do that really evenly. Again, adding enough water so that you can spread it out so it's not too dark and doesn't overpower all of those lines that you spent time on. If you don't have any spaces like that, don't worry about it, but do try to fill in each one of those sections. Okay? So moving on to the pumpkin. You can certainly do this again with crayons or colored pencils, or you can do it with paint. I do like how the paint works. So you should at home have a set of watercolors that has at least yellow, orange, and red in it. Mine here at school, I do have the 16 color ones. Some of you might have those as well. If you have those, you can start this off with a yellow, orange instead of yellow. But I'm keeping the center of my pumpkin very light. I know my lighting is a little bit weird here with this document reader. Let me see if I can switch, turn that a little darker. No, that doesn't help. Yeah, that doesn't help at all. So I'm going to just keep it as is. Okay. So I have mine, I started off with yellow, but I did go over it with a yellow orange. Once I have that done, I'm going to just take my regular orange and I'm going to fill in the whole rest of my pumpkin. And I'm not going to touch that yellow, that lighter section, until I absolutely need to. And then I'll show you that in a second. So I'm filling all that in with my orange. When I'm just about ready to blend them, when I'm ready to touch, I am just going in little circles and trying to blend that orange with my yellow middle. Oh wow, you really can't see that very well at all. From there, I'm going to take my red or my red-orange, and right along the edges, I'm going to add that darker tone. If it looks too red to you, all you need to do is go over top of it with some orange. So I'm going to take my orange again, and I'm going to just make sure that that is all blended as evenly as I can make it. Okay? You don't want it to look stripey. You can always just take a clean, wet brush, and you can blend it all together even more. Okay? For these next sections, so I'm going to just start right near the middle, or not near the middle, near the edge on either side with my lightest color, this. I'm going to fill in the whole rest of it with orange, making sure I have plenty of water so that it blends and spreads easily. It shouldn't be scratchy. Okay. I'm going to go in those little circles at this point and blend that orange with my yellow. Okay. And then the last step is to take that red right on the edge of that Sharpie line. Oops, I went over mine. Right along there, and then I can just wiggle it down the line to blend it even more. Okay. So when it's all done, it should have some highlights and medium tones, and it should look like a more realistic pumpkin. I apologize for the poor lighting on this document reader. It's not the best, but I think if you listen to what I was doing, and listen to the words that I used, and not so much looking at the color, I think you'll get the hang of it, okay? So it's lighter towards this middle bump, and then it gets darker as it goes out. So I'm going to put my darkest hue, my darkest value, right along the edge there. Okay. For the stem, kind of the same thing. I'm going to just take some brown. You can do this with green, too, if you'd prefer. But, oops, yep, I just took purple. I'm going to take some brown and put it near the edge and around the bottom. You see it's kind of dark there. And then I'm going to get my clean brush. Wow, that really doesn't look brown in the camera. Get a brush and just spread that out. If that's not enough shading for you, you can take a little bit of black, little bit of black, and add it around one of the edges, and then at the very bottom. Okay, and you can do that with two different greens as well. Okay, so that is how you're going to add color to this project. Oops, that's going to not help like that. Oh, there, that helped with that. Okay, anyway, we have it light in the middle here, and then darker as we go out, trying to stick to mostly orange because pumpkins are orange. Okay, on the bumps on either side, light here towards the middle, and then it gets darker as you go out. So I did yellow, orange, and then added a little bit of red. Okay, so give that your best shot. These are due on Friday, although you won't lose any credit if you turn it in on Monday. That will be fine. I know I took a little bit of time to post this, so do your best. And I look forward to seeing your project. Have a great night, everyone.